All right, I forgot to do a summary for the intro. So if you like lyrics, random new Riot news, and floral wallpaper, then just keep watching because it's all in here. Hello and welcome to vlog 35. One thing I've been asked quite a bit since the album's release is who played or sung on what and who wrote what lyrics and what they mean and that kind of stuff, especially for the more personal songs. So what I thought we'd do for a few vlogs is sort of do a deep dive into some of the songs. So for today's, we're going to look at the lyrics for Got Your Back, which were written by my bestie and bandmate, Fandangle and New Riot's Tommy T. So let's hop straight into a video call I had with him. Hey man!
Alright Andy, how's it going?
Good, thanks man, how are you?
I'm alright.
Loving the wallpaper, it's beautiful.
It's floral.
It is very floral. It goes with your vegan diet. So for those that don't know, this is my friend Tommy Saunders. We've spent many, many years on tour together in Fandangle and New Riot. We've been stage mates. In fact, we always used to insist on standing next to each other on stage.
I think we had to. I think if it was split between... I think I got lost in the music if I wasn't right next to you.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, who else would be there to like hit you in the head with his bass and stuff like that? It really did happen. But yeah, no, so on our album, there's a song called Got Your Back, and I left the lyrics completely to Tom, and I thought we'd deep delve into that part of the album today and talk to Tom about them. So you ready for that, Tom? You up for that?
Yeah, let's do it.
Sick. So let's delve into the lyrics first of all. So obviously, I think I gave you the song name Got Your Back as a code name, but where did the lyrics come from for you?
So I kind of wanted to encapsulate what we used to do like previously. So when we used to tour in Fandangle and New Riot, and basically trying to hold onto those memories. I mean, as the years go by, everything changes. We evolve as people. You know, some of us have families and everything like that. So what I wanted to do was really try and put a message across to delve into your mind, to delve into the past you've had and try and hold on to it and remember it, you know, remember those feelings you had, remember the drive you had that kind of pushed you forwards and also try and hold on to it, you know, just to do as much as you can with it.
Yeah, I think it ties in really well to the, because we used to write quite positive lyrics in Fandangle and New Riot. They were always about kind of stand up, get out and do what you want. It's a nice continuation of that, I feel. So it has a really nice personal moment. It kind of feels like it tells a story of what we used to do. So it's like a little time capsule of back to 2006 or whatever.
that's what I wanted to bring, especially for the album that you put out. I wanted to make sure that you had a track like that on it.
For sure.
But when you personally listened to it, you went, oh yeah, you know, I remember these times and how far you've come, you know, how far we've come as people from that point.
For sure, for sure. Well, I mean, you now have two kids and your lovely wife and two very crazy dogs.
Yeah, they are crazy.
They are crazy.
Very lively house. Very, very lively house.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think it's nice to look back on those times. I've got such fond memories of our times in those days. It's always really good fun. And lots more to come, I'm sure, in our nice little group. Mate, so obviously not only your lyrics are in there, but we've also got MC Lars, who's an old touring buddy of ours as well. And he even mentions Yeovil Ski Lodge in it, which is kind of where we met him actually back in the day. What were your first thoughts when you heard his part?
Well, to be honest with you, I think he was the best person to have on that track to do that little section, because he knew Fandangle very well. We've known him for a very long time. And we played with MC Lars in many festivals and shows. And,
yeah.
And when I heard the lyrics back, I thought he'd really, really nailed it. Like,
yeah.
He really nailed it. I was very happy when I heard it. It's quite exciting to be on a track with him as well, to be honest with you.
Yeah, it's a nice way for like our group to come full circle. Because like you say, yeah, we've got a good past with Lars. And yeah, I mean, I think when he asked me about it, because I gave him a blank space and I just said, it's kind of like about the friendships we used to have and the day, you know, the days we lived together and as a band, you know, kind of thing. I always feel like we lived on that bus more than we lived at home. But yeah, I think he nailed it. And he's such a friendly, personable guy that yeah, it's just such a positive thing. When he comes in, it's just like, aw.
Yeah, it's always nice. I think I remember playing, Fandangle played Slam Dunk Festival, I don't know how many years ago now. I lose track of time, to be honest with you. But I remember turning around to the left and just seeing him standing there on the side stage and just thinking, oh, this is cool.
Yeah, proper stand-up guys. That's such a nice part of the scene. He's always gives everyone the time of day. Like, he knows everyone. He remembers everyone. He watches everyone's sets. He like always offers cool like feedback. And you know, he like really pays attention. He's like, yeah, super inclusive of everyone, which is lovely. So it's nice to have him on it. Yeah, it's really good. Mate, so you've also been in lockdown with your kids. Any tips for people still in lockdown and how you've been getting through?
I think we actually touched a little bit on this a little while ago. Rum. it's hard work. I think everyone's going through it, whether you've got kids or not. I think your mental health is really, really important in these times when you're kind of locked in.
Yeah.
But like I said, whether you've got kids or not, it doesn't really matter. I mean, the kids bring a lot of joy and they can bring a lot of stress. I think the main thing is just to make sure you communicate, stay in touch with people. Don't just kind of get locked away with it. Although we've done Zoom calls. We've done, was it Bingo Bongo? Which is quite a cool game.
Yeah, for those that don't know, we have a really nice sort of Fandangle New Riot group WhatsApp thread, and we were having weekly Zoom quizzes at first, until it got to the point where nobody wanted to win, because if you won, you had to make the next quiz, and it was quite a lot of work. After about 15 quizzes, everyone was like, don't win. And then Ed turned into Bingo Bongo, where Ed kind of like makes up funny phrases for every number that don't really make sense, but they are genuinely hilarious, gets prizes of like lottery tickets and scratch cards, and usually has a couple of wines before, so it's absolutely hilarious.
No, it's really good fun. It really is good fun.
But it's definitely made like lockdown feel like quicker, like having that to look forward to every week, sort of catching up with our group of mates, because obviously we all grew up getting used to being in each other's pockets day in, day out, like for most of the year, every year. And so it's nice to see everyone once a week. That's really good.
Yes, it is. It really is.
So, mate, totally random question then. When I told you about this, because I'm just purely curious, when I first told you about this project idea years ago, what was your first thought?
To be honest with you, it was expected from you. Like, if anyone was going to go and do this outrageously kind of outlandish project, it was going to be you. Because you have this, it's in your blood, being a musician or music or just anything to do with creativity in that way. It's part of you. It always has been.
Sure.
So when you told me about it, I thought, yeah, go for it. I also kind of expected it to take 4 years. But one thing I didn't expect was the sheer amount of musicians that are on it. And I think having 100, I mean, I didn't even think that you could have 172 musicians on that album. I honestly thought that you'd have maybe a couple of musicians per track.
Yeah.
And then when you find out, it's like 172, and you think, wow. And it really, it comes through on that sound. It comes through. I mean, I've listened to the whole album over and over and over. And I must admit, I love every track on it. And I think that every single one's got a personal touch.
Yeah.
I wasn't surprised when you brought that thing. I brought that to my attention. And then the next thing I know is like you're in America touring with an acoustic guitar that went everywhere with you. and then you'd just be popping up all over the world. You're like, whoa, okay, he's really doing it.
Yeah.
You should be proud of yourself, man. It's awesome.
Thanks, man. So as the conversation went on, I think we kind of forgot we recorded an episode at times and just started chatting, which is really good fun and exactly how I'd want it to be. We got onto the subject of New Riot. Now, for anyone that's a fan of that band or knows who that band actually is, there's a couple of bits of info in there on what's coming next for that band. It's kind of separate to our plans here at Andy B in the World, but I thought it might be of interest to some, so I'll let it play on now.
You finishing it was actually, I suppose, yeah, a bit of a nice surprise that you actually finished that. Because
yeah.
There's other things that we haven't finished, isn't there?
I know. Do we tease? We are, so for those that don't know, we are working on new Riot material of some form.
Yeah.
We're not giving ourselves the pressures of time or kind of making promises. I think we have enough of those with this project. Yeah, I'm pretty proud of what we've done. I think what we've done together sounds inherently new Riot. It's kind of like a return to original form, because obviously the band kind of changed as it went, and we're kind of, I suppose it's natural with it being you and I do writing again, well, you, me, Ed and Craig really writing at the forefront, it kind of, it sounds like that first album did.
How does it sound? there's a sound that we kind of we bring out. But also without the added stresses, without actually putting across dates or times or whatever, without those stresses, you can really enjoy the hobby that you can. I mean, I picked up a guitar when I was 7, you know, and started singing when I was maybe 12 or 13.
Yeah.
And the reason I did that was because I absolutely loved it, and it made me feel free. You know, I could put my emotions, and I could tell stories, and I could do whatever I wanted to do as an extension to myself being a guitar, you know?
Yeah.
And I think it's vital that you hold on to these things. Like, you can take it to a next level. You can go professional. But if you don't hold on to those, then I think you end up losing a bit of passion.
Yeah.
And stress ensues, and it's just not nice. So, to have a bit more of a laid-back approach, perhaps the music will, I think we'll be more happy with the music.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I think there's definitely, like, in the things we did, because we were having such a ball when because we made most of the demos in Ed's conservatory, I think, or it's like Liz's little spare room. And we just had, it was a blast. We were just drinking ciders and kind of just make writing tunes bit by bit together as they happened. And it was really fun. There's one song in particular we're debating with dealing with first, and I'm really chuffed to get out. It even starts with Craig faffing around. It doesn't even start with music. I don't want to give it away, but yeah, it's got, there's something Craig does that's really, really quiet. But yeah, it'd be fun. So that's kind of everything with the chat with Tom. I hope you enjoyed the deep dive into the lyrics. We're planning a couple more of those. The next one, hopefully with Karen, who used to be in Chase Long Beach, now in Unicorn Injection, who wrote the lyrics and sung on Won't Back Down, another one of the album songs. We are currently editing a music video for one of the album songs to come out hopefully next week, so keep your eyes peeled for that too. Oh, one last thing. For anyone that noticed when we travelled across the States back in 2017, we were carrying an old acoustic guitar with us that we bought in a guitar centre in California for about $60. It was pretty rough, but it actually sounded all right. Anyway, we got everyone that was on the project over there to sign it, and when we got to the furthest place on the East Coast, we actually left it with Josh from the Backyard Superheroes to pass on to anyone that might need it in a kind of pay it forward way. We started tracking down where it's got to, and it is still in one piece. We're just waiting to hear back from the person that has it currently, but we'll tell the story of it in another vlog because it's really interesting. It's not that we want it back, I'm just keen to see where it got to and find out its story. It's really interesting. Well, it is if you're me and you miss that guitar. Anyway, that's all for this week. Take care. Please do like and subscribe if you enjoy what we do. Leave a comment, say hello. It's always nice to read. And stay safe. We'll catch you guys soon. Take it easy. Bye bye. We got your back. We're on the same page. We'll write the story. Hey, do you want to be called Tommy Saunders or Tommy T?
Tommy Saunders.
Okay, cool.
Tommy T Saunders.
Tommy T. Anything else you want to add?
I think Tommy Saunders would be fine.
You can be like Tommy T. C. Saunders.
Tommy T. Saunders.
Tommy. Oh, right. Well, that's all the video we need. Thanks for that. That's great.